Hello everyone. First off, I hope you're enjoying this year's super exciting E3. I for one am so excited for the Reignited trilogy and loving all the videos so far. So just to kick things off, I'm Louis, also known as Alex Shadow. This is my first time speaking on YouTube. Hey there, nice to meet you. So please bear with me as I get to grips with the microphone. So whilst we're all rolling in hype from the awesome Reignited Trilogy videos today, I am finally releasing Genesis, the 3D modeler from my last video, or was it one of my last videos, which lets you view and move scenery and objects. For those of you who want to dive right into it, go ahead, check the description below for the links and all the info you need, but do know that Genesis is quite finicky to use, so I do recommend watching this video where I'm going to do a small project I like to call Raising the Hype Ship in Lost Fleet. Enjoy! Behold the glorious SSB. Brianda. So with both Genesis and SpyroEdit open, go into SpyroEdit, go to the Genesis tab, and then hit the Connect button and Send Scene button. We can use the camera in Genesis by using the scroll wheel to zoom, the space and the click to move, and the middle click button to rotate, like so. So to raise this ship, we're going to go into the mesh and raise the polygons physically. Since Spyro levels are divided into several sections, we need to select the sections first, which in Genesis are treated as objects. So to select objects, click this button up here, or the number 5 key, and select the objects that you want to select. You can hold down Shift to select multiple, and you can also drag the mouse to do a border selection. So we're just going to try and select every section that contains the ship here. If you ever accidentally do what I did here and select too much, you can deselect by holding down Alt and clicking. You can also toggle selections by holding down Control, and as you already know, you can hold down Shift as well to add selections. Okay, so we've selected all the level sections that contain the ship. However, we don't want to move the object directly because Spyro won't recognize that. It will recognize that with game objects, but not with scenery objects. So first of all, we need to select the polygons. To go into polygon selection, hit the number 3 key, and we can now select polygons directly. Sometimes the easiest way to select something is by selecting too much and then cutting down afterwards. In this case, selecting every polygon on the ship one by one would have taken far too long, so this is what we're doing. Alright, here goes nothing. So we're going to use the Move tool. There is also a Rotate tool up here and a Scale tool as well. Hotkeys are W, E and R for each of those, and we're just going to try and raise the ship, so YOLO! So actually, the level sections have a size limit, so just to make sure we're not exceeding that, I'm just going to lower the ship slightly. If we exceed the size limit for a level section, SpyroEdit just won't be able to fit it in, and it might end up looking a bit weird, so let's fix that. It's a little bit tilted, so we're just going to quickly correct that with the Rotate tool. That'll do. So with all that done, let's have a look in the game and see how it looks. Looking pretty good, a bit broken. The low poly model doesn't seem to be working correctly. That's something that should be working, but maybe for a future version. But other than that, that looks pretty good. Tip before we move on though, collision triangles also have a size limit, so don't make your polygons too big like this one. If you do, just expect the collision triangle not to reach as far as it should, and you might clip right through it. So yeah, bear that in mind. So a seasoned Spyro hacker might be used to the idea of using a moon jump to get up here, but we have something better. Going up. Sweet. Okay, so we are now quite a bit higher, and the game is already lagging at all the polygons it has to render. But this is really nice, it feels like I got my own ship now. Right, so I notice our sails are a little bit flying in the middle of the air, so we're just going to go into SpyroEdit and click Send All Objects under the Genesis tab. And that gives us all the objects in the level, so we can now move them around or rotate them.
Yeah, so I figure if we are going to plunder the ship, the first thing we should do is put my newfound booty on display.
Oh, I think we missed a spot when we raised the ship. Let's just fix that. That'll do.
Yarr, but we still need to replace the sails.
That'll do. That'll do. That'll do, that'll do, that'll do, do, do. That'll do. Not too shabby, but
we need more.
So we're going to decorate the ship. I'm just going to find some pieces around the map, throw them together and see what they look like. BRB. Holy cow, this actually went way better than I thought. The SS Bryander is ready to set sail. Man, I'm really happy with how this turned out. Look at this, I got treasure. I got food, whatever that is. Got invincibility, I got my own crew, got cannons, as you were, Zoe. I got candles, I got me treasure chest, and I also got an egg? I thought I had an egg. Wait. Okay, I apparently don't have an egg, even though I should. But you know what? Life's great. I got my own ship. We're going to set sail straight to September 21st. It's going to be amazing. You can call me Captain Spyro.
Aye, so the last thing I reckon we need to do to set sail is get rid of this massive obstacle they call Lost Fleet.
So we're going to try deleting the whole level. Bear in mind, this is something you should do with caution. Deleting anything in Genesis is quite dangerous because if you delete something, Genesis won't necessarily be able to tell where the collision polygons below if you try to reload it. So bear that in mind. Since we're pretty much done here, I'm just going to try and delete everything anyway, see what happens. And yeah, we'll see how it goes. Well, that was way more trouble than it was worth, and I may have had to add a little hack into the code, but if we ignore that giant mess of polygons to the left, we are ready to set sail. Thank you for watching and joining me on the SS Bryander today. Hope you enjoy the rest of E3, and I join you all in excitedly waiting for Spyro 2 and Spyro 3. I can't wait to see that remastered. Give SpyroEdit a try in the meantime. I do apologize if it doesn't behave, it is quite broken. I don't expect to be updating it regularly, but it is on GitHub now, so if you're a programmer, check that out. But for a while at least, I will be releasing a video for each update, so don't go refreshing the SpyroEdit webpage over and over. You don't need to do that. And finally, if you want to ask me anything, you can message me on Reddit or comment below. While I don't make videos that often, I do tend to keep an eye on my comments, so feel free to ask me anything. That's all from me today.
Yeah, Captain Spyro out.
Oh dear.